What's a big mistake you see a lot of upcoming DJs do now?
A lot of mistakes?
Yeah, upcoming DJs
do. Or one mistake that you see?
Not knowing their worth. Mm. I think that the biggest problem for me with a lot of DJs that are coming up, not knowing your worth. Like, you're doing parties just for next to nothing. Right. It's terrible.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I don't care what kind of DJ you are. I don't care what you do. But you should get paid for that talent.
Right.
I think that, you know, I always said that to a lot of people, that doing parties for $200, $100, that don't really serve a purpose, man.
Right.
A pair of sneakers don't cost $100.
Not no more.
Not no more.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so what are you really gaining from that?
Right. So you think, because a lot of DJs doing it.
Right.
And a lot of promoters know about it. So, like, if this guy don't take, if DJ was Pee-wee we have on the show?
Oh, yeah. DJ Pee-wee, that's how I make believe DJ.
DJ. If Pee-wee don't take it, then the next person going to take it.
Right. So it's like, I get it, but that's the problem.
That's the problem, yeah.
Like, they don't know the worth. Right. They're their own worth. Mm-hmm. Like, I choose not to be in a club, right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't choose to be in a club because if I'm not getting the money I want, mm-hmm. why would I be in a club?
Right. It's a life.
What am I going to the club for?
Right.
Think about what your life is in a day.
No.
What you spend in a day outside.
Right.
Yeah. What's it
you
worth?
Spend an easy $150 walking outside your first 15 minutes.
Right.
Yeah.
That's from gas to getting something to eat. Mm-hmm.
Tolls or whatever, tolls, yeah.
Whatever it is. So how do you figure throwing on a pair of sneakers and going to a club?
Right.
Your sneakers cost $300-$500.
Right, right. To get that
Tim's
change.
At a time was $100.
Right.
Tim's now is almost $200 to $300.
Yeah.
The good days.
And you buy the new special edition ones.
Oh, here we go with the special.
$300. Exactly.
I'm just saying,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, no, you're right. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, everybody has a different comfort zone. I get it. But you should know your worth.
Right.
And I'm not saying, yo, you got to get wild bread.
Right.
But get paid what you deserve. Deserve.
Right. But also that comes up to, like you said earlier, there's 4 or 5 DJs in one night now. And
yeah, so $100 each, that's $500. Right. You know what I mean?
And homeboy at the door made 40.
40.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. That's how it is, yeah. Unfortunately, that's the times we've come
that's
upon.
That's the only thing I see wrong, man.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's a bad situation.
I think us DJs, the OGs, need to get into the, if they want to, the nightlife and get their own club. So at least they know how to hire the right DJ.
Yeah.
Have the right equipment for them. You know what I'm saying? And run the club the way it's supposed to be run.
Right.
You know, a lot of these people who have clubs nowadays, you know.
They don't even have equipment.
Yeah.
A lot of clubs, you got to walk in with your own controller.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not paying you for that neither.
Nope.
So you're $150
pay for that,
and you're walking in with a controller.
They pay you to promote the party.
You're going in negative
right.
in the bank already.
Right.
And then
your laptop costs
$3,000, $3,000-$4,000 mm-hmm. if you get a good one.
I mean, yeah. Let's say they get a MacBook Pro, you're still paying $1,200.
Right. Yeah. Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So where does it make sense?
Right.
Your scale is definitely on the other side. It's not even balanced.
And I don't think we can even stop that.
You're not going to be able to stop that.
Nah, because the younger generation, is they super disrespectful right now.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's one thing. And they don't want to hear what we got to say.
Right. Well, some do, though. Some do listen. I got a lot of cats that listen. It's just how you talk to certain people.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You can't force nobody to do nothing.
Right.
These young cats, they're going to do whatever they want to do.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of cats that are listening.
And that's good. That's good to hear, though.
Yeah.
There's a lot of cats that will listen. If you give them the time, they'll listen. People ask for advice. People want to know what can they do different.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Those are great conversations to have, because especially if it's you trying to tell them not to make the same mistakes that you may have made. You know what I mean? So you give them almost like a cheat code to get ahead. You know what
I'm
saying?
Well, it's going to be always different, because what works for me is not going to
work for you.
Right, correct.
You know what I'm saying? But you can give a jewel that I always tell people, that longevity is better than short term.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm a firm believer of, I've been in this game for years, it made me an animal. There's rules to this shit.
Right.
You know what I mean? That Biggie line is forever my shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm going to say that till the day I die.
Right.
And yes, I've been in this game for years.
Pretty much teaching a man to fish. You know, I could provide you with food every day. But if I take you to the sea and show you how I got this fish, then you'll be able to feed your family forever. That's that long-term money.
Yeah, but not everybody's going to grasp that concept.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, the theory of the mind for a lot of people, it doesn't work that way.
Yeah.
Because we fail to realize a lot of kids are failing where parents are not there for them like that.
Mm-hmm.
See, like, I've been fortunate. My mom's was there for me. My mother was, you know, te quiero la calle. I don't want you in the street.
Right.
You know what I mean? I don't want you hanging outside doing this or doing drugs.
I'm keep you home doing this.
This is what you want to do. Let's do this at home.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So a lot of kids don't have that.
Right.
Yeah.
So that's the misguidance that's going on in the world.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's sad.
No, it is. It is. It's very sad.
But these kids are willing to hear if you speak to them the right way. If you try to, it's like anybody. If you try to force somebody to do something they don't want to do, of course they're not going to fuck with you.
We didn't do it. We were forced when we were younger.
Right. Exactly. We had to learn the hard way. Right. So you got to let them learn the hard way. Mm-hmm. But if you give somebody guidance where the hard doesn't become so hard,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like when my mom used to say all the time, my grandmother, God rest her soul. El que no oye consejo nunca llega viejo.
Right.
Whoever doesn't listen to the wise word will never get old. Mm-hmm. And it's the truth.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's the truth. Like, it's the same thing as a DJ, a rapper, anybody in the industry, anybody in the commercial world.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not paying attention to what you believe in, it's not going to work.
Yeah.
Not everybody's going to be a millionaire, but we're going to keep hustling to make it to where we got to do to get what we need.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. Get to eat.
You can't just quit.
Yeah.
I keep on going.
Yeah, there's going to be bumps in the road.
But you don't want to sell yourself short neither. Mm-hmm. Because that's going to make it harder.
Right.
Yeah.
Any of those young DJs that are listening?
Oh, I got DJ Spazzo. Static Selector was one cat that was under my wing. So many other D's, I can't remember. But you know what I mean? Like, I helped a lot of people that's in the game. You know what I mean? And giving them guidance helps a lot of people. Just a simple talk.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You're not saying
you're doing wrong. Just
right. Just make sure you put yourself first.
Right.
Yeah.
Don't try to put yourself somewhere just because.
Right.
Like, you trying to fit in and because this guy's there and he's DJing and you're not, your time will come.
Right.
As long as you put in the work, the time will come.
Consistency. Yeah.
But your name, build your brand.
Yeah.
And that's the thing. You got to build your brand.
You got to put in the hours. Yeah.
Up. It's coming from
words from the OG.
OG, you know what I'm saying?
And I'll be honest, man, I've reinvented myself times and time again. Yeah. You know what I mean? And I'm still here.
Right.
Still doing what I love.
Right. And you just did it recently with Twitch.
And yeah, exactly. Twitch is
paying the dividends.
It's a new platform you had no clue about.
I had no, like, I'm always willing to learn. I'm always willing. The only shit that I don't care about learning is the Ableton bullshit.
Right.
Just because I don't got it down pat yet, but I got to learn that shit because I got to learn how to fuck with that shit.
Yeah, it's good to record mixes and shit like that.
You use it, don't you?
Yeah, because you can record right from Serato into Ableton.
Yeah, I know, you make it sound so easy. Great to record. Right? Same thing as this guy over there, my guy Danny S, he tells the same shit. Right? It's just amazing. Yeah,
it's dope. I was the same way, and then one day I finally sat down. I said, I need to learn this shit. And I learned
how to my son be trying to tell me, but it's just like, it's hard for me, man. It doesn't resonate with me.
It'll click. Eventually, you'll be like, Fuck. I'm good on Adobe. You're doing an audition? Adobe Audition.
I'm old school.
Yeah, that's what's up. That's another great program.
I started on Cool Edit.
Oh, damn.
Right back.
Yeah, that's what's up. What's your thought on female DJs?
They dope. A lot of female DJs are dope. Mm-hmm. But I don't really categorize female DJs as
a female
DJ. They're DJs.
Right? They're just DJs.
Because, you know, one of my closest friends, which is Jazzy Joyce, Coco Chanel.
Yeah.
They DJ.
They're better than some men out there.
You know what I mean? Like they DJ. Yeah. So I don't take that away from them.
Yeah.
You know, DJ Pearly, she's
right, Pearly, yeah.
She's dope.
Insane. I did number two-time winner.
Beverly Bonds.
Yep, Every, Bonds,
there's a lot of female DJs, you know what I mean, that put in work.
I think, you know, that question we need to rephrase it because it's not, like you said, a female DJ is a DJ.
Right.
I think the media is separating the female DJ.
Well, the media separates everything.
Everything, right. Yeah. But that's what they're doing. They're separating the female DJs from a male DJ.
DJ is a DJ.
DJ is a DJ. Yeah. If you put that, you know, hopefully you understand what the D and the J stands for to put that before their name.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I think female, male, they both a DJ no matter what.
Yeah, like I don't like to categorize female male DJs.
Because I know a lot of female DJs that are better than male DJs.
There's definitely.
Yeah. Absolutely. What's one genre of music that you listen to that people wouldn't think that you listen to?
Spanish. First of all, nobody believes I'm Puerto Rican. You look at me and you're gonna be like, he's black. He's not even Puerto Rican. You know what I mean? Like So I listen a lot of Spanish.
Salsa, merengue, bachata.
Cumbia. I listen to everything, but I listen to salsa more than anything.
Okay.
In my car.
Do you listen to music after a gig in your car?
On your way home.
Salsa.
Salsa.
Or Danny S. Blend Tape.
Okay.
Or Ty Boogie. Like, I listen to blends.
Okay. Yeah, creative stuff.
Yeah.
And besides the tour you're working on right now, the album or is it EP?
It's an album.
Album. Anything else you're working on?
Nah, not right now. My health. That's the only thing I've been working on is my health.
Right.
Be a year and 9 months now. Consistency in the gym went from 390 to 250.
God bless.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's really my thing is gym every morning.
Yeah, I need to get in there. Morning.
One day at a time. All I can tell anybody is one day at a time. It's not going to happen overnight.
I told you to get the book. It's called Atomic Habits. You
told me that yesterday.
All right.
Okay.
I don't know if you ever heard of this book. It's called Atomic Habits. So basically, it's a great book. It's not a thick book. It's a thin book. So basically, what this book is teaching you, habits, right? So let's say, like, he wants to start going to the gym, right? So every day you wake up and you start a habit. So tomorrow he's going to wake up at 5 a.m. But he's not going to go to the gym. He's just going to wake up, right? Then he's going to wake up the next day, get up, brush his teeth. He's still not going to go to the gym.
Why he ain't brush his teeth?
Let's say he just wakes up and he stays in bed. You know what I'm saying? So you're starting steps.
So you don't brush your teeth every day? That's what you're saying?
No. I'm confused.
Next day, I'm going to wipe my ass the next day?
No, what you're going to do is you're slowly conditioning your body to wake up at 5 a.m.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So you wake up at 5 one day, and that's your first step. The next day, 5, brush your teeth. Next day, 5, brush your teeth, get dressed, right? Next day after that, wake up, brush your teeth, get dressed, go out to your car, right? Don't leave, but go out. The next day after that, you get in your car, you start your it's a condition. It's 21 days, right? To make a habit or break a habit. After that, then you're going to go to the gym, and then you'll work out for the hour. And then by then, it's your body's condition. You will naturally wake up by yourself at 5 a.m.
Man, let me tell you something, man. That's not going to work for me. Listen, here's the thing.
I'm not conditioning. Either you're going to do it or you're not going to do it.
That's the bottom line.
Right.
But what I'm telling you is one day at a time.
One day at a time.
Even if you went to the gym and just did treadmill for 15 minutes, mm-hmm. and you broke out. You did something.
Did something, right.
See, me, I didn't plan it. I was doing Twitch.
Okay.
So what happened was I was losing weight on Twitch.
Oh, dope.
If a man does 10,000 steps a day, you're in the right direction. 10,000 steps a day is what helps your heart.
But also you have to change the way you was eating too.
Yeah, I did do that. Okay. I did change the way I was eating.
Because he could do 10,000 steps to the fridge and back.
Yeah, but you can do that, but make sure you drink a lot of water.
Let's keep it a buck.
Leave the soda and all that shit alone.
Okay. Right.
But, like, I'm not on a diet, see? I could eat whatever I want.
Right.
I just don't eat the way I was eating.
It's a lifestyle change.
Right. It's a lifestyle. It's a definite lifestyle. Like, what I'm doing now is a lifestyle. Like, right now, they just mad water, fasting, making sure whatever I eat makes sense. Mm-hmm. I don't count calories. I don't.
You're eating in moderation.
I don't have a scale going, you know, I'm going to eat this amount, eat that. I'm not doing that. But I do eat periodically.
Right.
You know what I mean? I'm not eating eight times a day. Like they say you're supposed to eat eight times a day. Right. I'm not eating eight times a day. Yeah, it's not going to happen.
So your metabolism is constantly going.
Yeah, you could burn your metabolism without that.
Yeah.
I'm being honest. Like at my age already, I'm already at a certain age that it's gonna happen.
Right. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, the older you get, the more you're accessible to eating less.
That's...
All you gotta do is make sure you get rest. You gotta sleep.
Yeah.
Cause that's a big factor when it comes to that.
Super important.
Is that. Is the sleep and then rest your body. See, I OD'd, right? So 4 months ago when we was on tour, I was going to the gym twice a day. I was going 7 days a week. When I came back, couple of weeks ago, body crashed.
It said, yo,
shut
that's
down.
Enough.
Because I didn't let my body rest.
Okay. Mm.
So I was consistently busting my ass, going to the gym. I felt great, but then my body just shut down.
It was like, yo, that's enough.
Yeah, because I was doing too much. Mm. So now I had to slow down. So now I'm down to 5 or 6 a week. But I was going hard while I was on tour. Because I wanted to really, like, get my shit right.
Get fit, yeah. You work on your summer body.
Nah, it wasn't even about summer body. Is
it more of your health? Yeah.
It was, like, you know, like, I didn't plan it, so.
Yeah, you're doing it for yourself.
For me, it was really, like, I was borderline diabetic.
Okay.
I was shooting insulin. Mm-hmm. I had reversed that.
So you could reverse it.
But no, there's
two different.
It's type one and type two. You was type one?
Type two.
Type two?
Yeah, okay. Type two is the one you could reverse. It's all due to
It's due to
the way you eat.
Right.
Yeah. My son is diabetic. So yeah.
I'm type 2. He's type 1. Yes, sir.
Yeah. He's type 1.
Yeah. Like, born with it is different.
Yeah.
That's a different. You can't. Yeah.
He works out. You know, he plays a lot of sports and stuff, and that helps him. And there are famous NFL players and stuff like that do have type 1.
Yeah, so there's a lot of people that have.
But it's the same thing. We have to weigh his food and measure his carb count. But
that's different.
I wish, I really wish, you know, fortunately he is healthy, but he has to live with it now for the rest of his life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Unfortunately.
But as long as he keeps himself right, he's good. Because a lot of people right now dealing with that diabetes, they're losing toes.
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
They're losing limbs.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And eyesight. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah. And I've been fortunate enough through everything that I did, I let myself go. Like, I really did.
Right.
And that shit was crazy.
Right, right.
But then to reverse it, not to be on insulin, not to be on all those meds.
Yeah, congrats on that.
You know what I mean? Thank you. It's a blessing.
Yes.
So that plays a big part.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to be stuck with that.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. And I don't want to be, like, I can remember sitting on the couch. I used to eat off my stomach. Like, literally, I would eat. I had my phones on my joint. Like, I can remember that. Like,
yeah, lift up.
Like, I had my phones on my stomach, like, just sitting, like,
chilling. Yeah.
Can't even do that no more. Like, I don't got that no more.
And that's what's up, yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's a blessing to be able to say, yeah, I'm 53 years old, bro.
Yeah, I'm about 50 this year.
I'm going to be 54 this year.
Yeah.
Look, blessed.
But you look damn good for your age, too.
Nah, but that's why, because I took care of myself.
Right.
Yeah.
Because there's people that are really sick behind this.
Yeah, mm-hmm. No, for sure.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's really sad that minorities don't go to the hospital. Men don't go to the hospital.
No, we hard-headed. We stubborn. We stubborn.
You know what I mean? I go to the hospital. I've been a kid since I was a kid. My mother told me, make sure your underwear and your T-shirt is clean.
You're in the doctor's.
Go to the doctor's. If you got a pain, go to the doctor.
Yeah.
And I would go in a heartbeat. Like, I'm not wasting time with it.
No, yeah, and a lot of people do. You can't.
And a lot of men do, and they wait till the last minute. And it's 7 days of coughing.
It's too late.
They bleeding out their rectum. Then they wondering why.
Why?
Yeah.
You let yourself go.
You had signs. You just didn't. You didn't see it and take heat on it.
Right, and then you don't. You know, we act like we'll take Tylenol. We'll do. Do this, do that.
And those are the worst pills.
In the Puerto Rican household, you just drinking ginger ale or some shit.
Oh, ginger ale or beat that. Or Vicks.
Vicks,
everything. LV.
That's what I did when I had the, when I caught COVID, I used it, honey and Vicks. That's all.
Damn. So if you could have done something different on your path, you know, to your path to success right now, what would it have been in hindsight?
I don't think I would have did anything different. I don't regret nothing I've done. And to be honest, you know what I mean? As a DJ, as a person, I don't regret. I mean, you know, the only thing that I could really say is sometimes you got to choose your friends wisely.
Yeah, so not all the
you
time.
You know what I mean?
That's all the time, yeah.
That's the only thing that I could say is, you know, the people you think are really, like, for you are really not for you.
Mm.
But I've been fortunate, you know, to come across the people that I've had all these years as true friends, you know what I mean?
And yeah,
that's a blessing. The ones you did meet, whatever,
keep it moving.
But yeah, the ones that's been in your life, supporting you and loving what you do and being there for you, those are the ones you gotta take account for.
Yeah, sometimes friends become family,
right?
And sometimes your family is not your friend.
Not your friend.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, which is terrible.
And neither is your biggest fan your best friend.
Right. Yeah. Sometimes your enemy could be your best friend. You don't even know it. You know what I mean?
So, I know this question right next I'm about to ask you. It's going to be hard for you to pick because you've been in the game for such a long time. Five DJs, your top five DJs now and your five top DJs before.
When you first started DJing.
When I first started DJing, my top DJs was Grandmaster Flash, Brucey B, Kid Capri, Charlie Chase, and then I'm going to have to say DJ Squirrel, which was a local DJ around my block. And then DJs now. I'm going to say Technician, a DJ.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's been with me since he was a young boy.
Shout out to him. Facts.
That's my guy. After that, I have to say Kid Capri, Brucey B still.
Still going strong.
Clark Kent.
Yeah.
And then after that, it'll be SNS.
Yep.
He's on tour now with Mary J. Blige.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. SNS. Mixtapes was fire.
Yes.
I bust SNS ass in Webster.
In Webster?
Yeah, I did. We battled and I bust his ass.
What
and
year
he
was
knows
this?
That. It was like 90 something. Ron G was there. Doo Wop was there.
Shout out to Ron G.
You know what I mean? So, but yeah, you know, those are people that have been inspiration. You know, after that, it's like, Craig G, that's my brother.
Top floor.
Kirk.
Yeah.
People that was always around me that, you know, shouts to Danny S, Todd Boogie. Not because S is here, Danny S is here, but I've been a fan of Danny S for real.
And he spoke highly of you, by the way.
Nah, I've been a fan of Danny for years. You know, then there's other DJs like Danny D. Spazzo, Static, Premier.
Yeah, of course.
You know what I mean? There's a lot of cats that,
Jazzy
Jeff, you know what I mean? That are inspiration to me, the people that I've watched and I've learned from.
Yeah.
You know, my all-time, the people that gave me the inspiration to talent and personality is, you know, Kid Capri, Brucey B, Funk Flex. Those are the people that, you know, you cultivate that little niche from everybody.
Everybody. Mm-hmm.
But you make it your own.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's like, what's important. Yeah.
I didn't sit there trying to be
copying what they were doing.
What everybody else was doing. You know what I'm saying? So I had a way of learning how to do things, but being surrounded with people that gave you that insight.
Yeah.
From mixtapes to radio to the club.
Mm-hmm.
So those DJs really meant a lot to me.
Dope.
That's nice to hear.
Yeah. What's going on? Going to the game?
Want samples?
Yeah, let's go to samples. All right, so basically, we going to play the sample. You don't got to know the original sample. If you do, great. But let us know who used the sample. And also, we know that there's
multiple people
that used, you know, the same sample. So whatever comes to mind for you will be
the
what
answer.
We pick. And then we'll let you know what we want.
We want.
What we were expecting. Picked, yeah. What we picked for the sample type of deal.
What bank you on? Seven. Okay.
All right, let's go with the first one.
Eazy-E, N.W.A.
That's what we're looking for. Hey, one more time. The first. You got this.
You got this.
One more time.
It was in your crate.
In your crate for sure.
Which Eazy-E song you was talking about?
It's an N.W.A. song.
Okay.
That's an N.W.A. song that used that joint. I can't remember who y'all was looking for.
Play who he's looking for.
Smooth the Hustle.
I don't hear that sample in there.
In the beginning. Play the beginning again. Right there.
I'm going to debate that one. I don't think that's that. I don't think that's that sample, man. I'm going to be honest. I don't hear that. I'm gonna have to go to the encyclopedia about that one.
I'll say it to you.
That's definitely not a dun 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 dun.
That's what they loot the sample.
Honestly, play the sample again. N.W.A. I don't care what you say, man.
We'll give you that. We'll give that one.
I'm gonna try to find an N.W. record.
It's an N.W.A. record. Trust me, it's that. But that dude, hell nah, but go ahead. What's next? Oh man, that's Foxy Brown and Diddy. Who else used that?
That's the one that we have on the thing.
Is that one?
Yeah.
But somebody else used it too, though.
Yes.
The Locks used it.
Right.
Tech produced that for the Locks too. Dope. That was crazy. But all right, next.
Let's go next.
Oh, that's dun, 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 dun. Phone Tap.
Yep.
What's the dilly? I just touched grounds down in Philly, bought a pound.
Such a fire song. Yeah, let's go next, yo. Yeah.
Oh, that's Live at the Fever.
Right.
Crew used that.
Yep. With the Locks.
And one of the guys from Crew just died.
Did they?
Oh, yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, Crew and the Locks together.
Yeah. It's on for real. Word, yo. That was too easy, Chubb, yo. Let's go to A, yo. Let's go to A.
Come on, that's Nas, man.
Yeah, go again, go ahead.
Play it again?
He knows this one.
He knows this one, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Fat Joe?
Close. Big pun. Glamorous
Life.
Glamour lifestyle, baby.
Yeah. Boom. That was crazy, that windy jelly. That was airy. Like, I couldn't remember what that was.
He was there, though. Yeah.
He got it. It was Big Pun. But he got it.
Come on, man. That's Down for My Niggas.
Yeah, yeah.
That's Ike's move, B. That's world famous Brucey B shit. that joint plays in four keys. That frum, 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 frum.
All right.
He got a 7 out of 7 or 6 out of 7.
That was it?
That was it. It was only 4. We didn't stop.
Game was garbage.
You want some more? You want some more? We got more.
Wow.
We tried
I thought
y'all
was going to give me the stump, man.
He was trying to stump you.
We did.
We got it with the Smooth
the
Hustle.
The first one, I'm not believing that one, B. I'm not eating that, B. I'm not.
I'm going to send you that tonight or tomorrow.
I'm going to treat that like vegan. I'm not doing that one, B.
Yeah, let's see what you got.
That's Busta.
Yeah.
Rise.
Yeah, yeah.
Happy come body on, B. Rise.
Good. Yeah. You're
doing too much of a sample.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, play another one.
Come on, man. Don't do that. I'm not even. Come on. That was dumb easy, man. That's Hov, man. y'all gotta get better. Danny S better give y'all better loops.
Nah, yo, trust me, believe it or not, a lot of people we hear the samples.
Right.
Well, he doesn't tell me what they are. So right. Me, I'm with you. You know what I mean? And I hear them and I know them, but a lot of people, because they in the hot seat, they get stumped. And it's obvious.
Well, believe I mean, it or not. If you're not really into your music,
right,
then it's something like how you say you don't listen to albums.
Yeah.
That's how it is.
Yeah.
So like the pressure is on, like, oh, I don't, you know what I mean?
Right.
But
right.
This is shit that I do all day long.
Right.
That shit right there, loops, like technician and DJ is one of these guys that'll keep me, like even my man Jeff Two Times, they keep me on this,
on your feet.
This loop
on feet,
shit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like they produce and they figure shit out, and I be like, oh, what joint is that? And they're like, oh, that's this.
Right.
Now, if you ask me the name of the person's song,
right.
That's where y'all gonna stump me, because I don't know shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, I don't, especially lyrics.
He got a cheat code then.
Lyrics, I don't be knowing no lyrics.
Oh, we're going to lose on that one then.
Lyrics, I know
we got,
no.
We're going to get you right now.
Lyrics suck.
Since you called
this, this right here.
He said, this game ain't shit.
We got you right here, Margie.
Lyrics, you can forget about it.
So check this out. This is a game.
The hum song.
Right, so this game right here, it's called Lyrically Correct. We're just supporting it. It's a black-owned business, so we like supporting small businesses. You probably seen it on IG all over the place. So basically, you can pick this up at Amazon. So basically, I'm gonna read a lyric and you gotta finish it. All right. Some of them have multiple choice though.
Okay.
Don't get no choices though.
No multiple choice.
Nah. He caught our shit. He caught our shit.
Whack.
He got
your
whack.
You feelings?
Damn.
I was gonna donate loops to y'all.
I'm ready to go cry in the shower. You know what I'm saying?
I was gonna donate loops.
Yo, you gotta understand though. Yo, you gotta understand though. You know how many samples I had to pick for this weekend?
Yeah, for real. No, but you know, he kicked our ass with the samples.
He did.
We give you that.
He's like a DJ Danny Vintage.
Like Danny Vintage, right? Yeah. Right. So all right. So where was Biggie going?
Cali.
All right. See, you're not bad. You're not bad. Let's see. All right. Oh, these are easy for you too. According to the locks, what is the key to life?
Money, power, respect.
All right. And that one had multiple choice. Which magazine did Biggie read?
Source.
Nope. And Juicy.
Word up.
There you go. See?
Stumped.
Got him. And Nas won, Mike. After the cops shot again, the bus stopped, glass burst, and what did the first fiend drop?
Loss.
His Heineken. Yeah. All right, let's go one more. Here we go. According to Sporty Thieves, what kind of girl is fronting like she can't say hi?
Pigeon.
You can,
I was
on,
gonna
you
say
Gucci.
Cheapskate, but that was the
that was
other
another
song.
That was another song. You Gucci.
That's a dope game though. Yeah.
Nah, this basically it comes with a timer. You usually people,
oh you gotta get timed on.
Yeah, usually yeah. People, you know, I mean, and it's teamed to have challenge cards and play it when you're drinking or something like that. Make it more fun type of deal. But then, you know, shout out to Lyrically Correct. Great game. We love it. We support it.
You know we get nothing from them.
We don't get nothing from them. It's straight support. Yeah. You know what I mean?
That's
so.
Dope. I like that. That's
good. See,
we got a little something.
You caught the sample shit whacked. I don't know about that.
I gotta help y'all out, man.
Yeah, you're gonna have to.
You might have something.
We're gonna park.
You gotta pick the joints that are under the songs.
Yeah,
the song
yeah.
that not the joints that are sitting, because right. when they're sitting, it's easy.
Right.
It was
like
easy
right
for
now,
you, like I said.
Smooth the Hustler right now. That's I'm still stumped, but I'm going to go check that out.
I'm going to send it to you.
No, I'm going
to
check that
out. I'm going to send that shit to you.
I'm about to go to Who Sample.
That's where I go to.
I never knew that was that. Yeah. That's crazy.
And it came, obviously, I don't even know how I came up on the sample. I think I was looking under like Foxy Brown.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, it's like a category on Tyler Brooklyn. And then his name came up. So I remember this. I went to that.
That's one.
Then when I heard it, I was like, I was like you. I was like, I don't hear this shit. But then I put it, I kept on doing that. And then, okay, now. Dun, 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 dun.
That's still one of my I have a lot of favorite songs, of course, but that Smooth the Hustler joint is just hard.
No, that's classic.
Yeah, that joint right there.
That
man,
beat that is
Brooklyn
that
joint.
Beat is everything. That beat.
Yeah.
I'll never forget putting that shit on a mixtape off of Test Press. Like, come on, B, that shit was Smooth and Trigger and DV Christ.
DV Alias Christ, yeah.
There's gonna be three of them, right?
Smooth the Hustler. Trigger the Gambler.
Trigger the Gambler. Three,
and DV Alias Christ. Yeah. Dope song.
Dope group, too. I mean, they were all single artists, but together as the group. Mm-hmm.
Fire song.
Yeah, I did.
Forever but classic.
I'm gonna send to him.
It'd be in your inbox tonight.
So you were taking a drive from Boston to Orlando, and you had an old school CD changer in your trunk. You had to put in 10 CDs of any type of music. What 10 CDs that would be?
What year are we talking?
Any
year,
whatever. It's you.
Any category?
Driving.
Any mixtape? Could be anything.
It's open.
It's open.
And
any genre.
Whole genre.
Yeah, doesn't matter.
I'm going to say Reasonable Doubt.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say Big first and second album.
Okay.
Nas first album. I'm going to say Danny S R&B mixtape.
Mm-hmm.
Danny S and Precise Puerto Rico joint. SNS Swerve On. Ron G, number 13.
Okay.
And then I'm going to say my mixtape, Spring Fever 98. And then I'm going to go with, what would be the last joint? That'll be, man, that's kind of, I'm going to say Get Rich or Die Trying.
Yeah, classic.
That's 10.
You know, I find it, you know, what's funny is that, you know, you're a straight mixtape DJ because you knew exactly which Ron G,
right,
which Danny S. But when you said Nas first album, Jay-Z first album, you know what I'm saying? So I think that's dope. You know, that's really dope that, you know, because not many, you have to be a true mixtape head. There's a dude I follow on IG. He's from Brooklyn. I forgot his name. I'm terrible. I'm sorry, man. I can't remember your name, but he is a mixtape collector. He has walls and walls of mixtapes. I gotta remember his name.
Is it Mixtape Collector?
It might be. Let me I'm gonna see.
Are you doing that?
I gotta get his name.
How many mixtapes you had done?
How many I've done?
Yeah, you're done.
Is it Mixtape Classics?
I got all my shits too. I got my joints in a rack. I got like 100 mixtapes I've done. 100 masters that I've done.
You're done?
That I've sold.
Okay.
It's at least 100. 100 or something. After that, we went to CDs.
Right, the CDs. But total in your whole CDs, mixtape ever, what's the total number that you made?
How frequent were you dropping mixtapes?
Every month.
Okay.
And sometimes you had to wait because if you had the same songs that somebody had, you were kind of not selling your shit.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, you could sell it,
right,
but it wouldn't
reach that.
It wouldn't reach the mark that you wanted.
Right.
That's why I went to, from doing regular shit that niggas was doing, I was putting the artists that nobody was listening to.
Right.
So I started making dirt mixtapes. Mm-hmm. That's what I considered my underground.
Okay.
So I was the kid that came from Fat Beats and had a bunch of Company Flow and El Sensei and all these other guys rapping before people really paid attention to them.
Right.
So I had that lane. But if I had to say, I want to say like 250, 250.
Wow.
With CDs and tapes.
And right now, if anybody wants to get a copy of that, are they able to?
Some of them are
online.
Some of them are online, and I didn't put them though.
Okay.
But
we'll find out who that bootlegger is.
I put out a USB, and I put like my first 14 tapes that I did.
Mm-hmm.
I got it on a USB that I did.
That's dope.
And I put those on. I burned them myself.
Okay. Yeah.
So I've been trying to burn my tapes because everybody wants my old
tapes.
Right,
right, right.
But some of the joints that I've done, they're on YouTube. They're on Mixcloud. But yeah. I didn't put them there. Like people.
Yeah, fans. Fans put them up, yeah.
Like my Street Madness 96 is up there. Like anything that got Jay early, because I had Jay freestyle on a lot of my joints. And I played a lot of Jay-Z songs that nobody really had at the time.
Were you that DJ in the studio getting those on Dats?
Yeah, I had them on Dats because I used to make my tapes in Clark's house.
Okay.
Some of my tapes I made in Clark's house because I didn't have a DAT machine at the time.
Were you using like a 4-track or a 8-track,
no,
something like
just
that?
Straight turntable. Straight live? To the DAT.
Right. Dope.
I never did 4-track. Okay. Well, I did that after a while. I tried to do a mixtape with Tech. We try to do like the intro on the 2-track.
Like the Green Lantern, Green Lantern joint,
He did the intro though.
Yeah.
I'm not that.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like that's why I give creativity to like, you know, Technician the DJ, Danny S, Danny D, Green Lantern.
Right. The Jews, the
Precise.
Yeah.
P Nice, Craig G. Like they had that whole different aura of what it was to do intros and and make like Dirty Harry and shit like that. That shit was creative. Double R.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like that was creativity.
Yeah. Dope.
What you got, Corrette?
I'm good, man.
You do a movie thing before? He might call that trash.
Let's go. But go ahead. Let's go with this is his favorite question.
This is my favorite question. So best hip hop movie.
Best hip hop movie? Wild Style for me.
Okay. So that is a hip-hop movie.
It is a hip-hop movie.
So there's not many hip-hop movies in my book.
Nah, there is.
Okay.
You got B Street, you got Wild Style, you got Breakin'.
Breakin' 1, because I'm Breakin' 2.
I don't care about 2, but 1.
He's like...
Crush Groove.
Okay, I disagree with Crush Groove.
He's going to disagree with you all day on Crush Groove.
It was another one.
Why?
Because I think it was just based on a hip-hop label. That's it. It don't give us the elements of the hip-hop.
Honestly, you got to think about the element of what Run DMC was. They wasn't even a group at the time. They were just Daryl and Joe.
Daryl and Joe.
So that's the start of that whole situation, Run DMC.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a hip hop movie.
Right. Yeah. In my opinion, the elements of hip hop is not.
There was a lot of element in it. You got Sheila E. playing drums. You saw LL for the first time.
Right.
Fat Boys performed that disco.
Right. No,
fever.
You are actually 100% right. And I love the movie. As a younger, I love them. Into now, I can watch the movie. I love the movie. But it's not giving you the elements of hip-hop.
So he
the breaking, the
DJing,
graffiti, the DJ,
MCing, and graffiti. Like,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Now it's 5 elements. So
beatboxing. Yeah.
Beatboxing or the knowledge.
But it still gives you an element of understanding of music and artistry and what was going on in the music industry. So that is hip-hop. Okay. But we could agree to disagree.
Right.
I'm cool with it.
Right. Another one I always disagree also is Juice.
Juice, right.
Another one.
Huh?
So you don't think Juice is a hip-hop movie?
It's only give you 2 elements of hip-hop.
It only gives you the DJ.
And a little small part.
But then it gives you the DJ that gets caught up with the wrong people.
Right. Again.
I mean, that's hip-hop.
That's what I say. I'm with you 1,000%.
I'm from the Bronx. That's hip-hop.
And I say...
We used to steal records for the library.
Yeah.
I mean, that's hip-hop.
The big-ass sticker.
Once again, we could agree to disagree.
Right.
I mean, I was in the streets in the Bronx. Like, I knew what it was. Like, I would take a Sesame Street record and not bring it back.
Right.
Just so I could cut Big Bird.
Right.
You know, I'm being honest. Like, we were stealing records out of a record store, like...
Out of a library. Yeah,
so, I mean, it's just, you know, we all have different reasons for certain shit. Right. I mean...
That's what we asked the question
If
for.
We're looking for elements,
right.
I mean, I don't know, but hip-hop is such a broad thing for me.
It's a culture.
It's not even the culture aspect. Mm-hmm. It's the fact to the first time you got a pair of Pro Keds, my nigga. Like... Mm-hmm. I was a little kid. I couldn't even get Pro Keds. Pro Keds was $10.
Mm-hmm.
My father would not buy me a pair of Pro Keds. You know what I'm saying? Like, to getting a pair of Pumas, walking around with a brush so your joint don't get dirty.
Yeah.
You had one pair of sneakers for a whole 2 months.
Yeah, sometimes longer than that.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, like in my house, if my sneakers didn't have a hole in them, we couldn't get new ones.
Right, right.
Yeah, I know. We used to, and we spoke
so
about
as
this.
I got older, I was that kid that, oh, I'm buying, let me get three of those, let me get four of those. I used to work at Dr. J's. Mm-hmm. My check was going straight to
Dr. J.
It was in there.
Where, Fordham Road used to work?
On 49th. It was Joe Army and Navy before it became Dr. J.
Okay.
I worked there. I used to go to the club, Studio 54, mm-hmm. and go right to work. Mm-hmm. So sneakers was like everything. I remember buying my first pair of Jordans. Mm-hmm. I got stabbed in my Jordans. And the blood was all over my seat. I cleaned them joints.
Oh, my God.
My man was like, nah, you got to throw them out. I'm like, not throwing these out. This was $100.
Yeah. Did you get, was something happen that you got stabbed for the Jordans? Were they trying to steal the Jordans? Or?
Nah, we was on, I was at a house party on a Grand Concourse. And this guy was like, because I had a chain on. So okay. He was like, he told me in Spanish that he was going to cut my heart out. In Spanish.
Right.
But he didn't know I speak Spanish.
Mm, right.
So when I said, Agalo, he was like, so my man was like, nah, I ain't doing shit. So we started fighting on Grand Concourse. Mm. But he did stab me, though. Mm. Stabbed me right in my shoulder with a Rambo knife. Mm.
Damn, I'm glad you're good, though.
Yeah.
Shit is crazy. I've been stabbed in my shoulder. I've been stabbed in my side. I got shot in my face. Mm. You know what I mean? I'm here for a reason. God is good.
God is good. God is great.
Facts.
But hip-hop, I lived that shit. This is real. Like, I was the little fat nigga in front of the rope. Like, they used to be like, fat boy, get off the rope. And I was so in tune to watching the DJ.
You didn't hear it. You didn't hear him.
Nah, I heard him, but I just didn't want to listen.
Nah, it is what it is. Yeah.
I was like, yo, I want to know, what is that y'all doing?
Right.
What is that? Like, why is everybody moving?
Right.
Yeah.
I was little. I was like 9 years old. I was, fat boy, get off the rope. I hear the echo and everything. Fat boy, get off the rope. Like, it was crazy. Like, I lived that. First time going to Tremont and Arthur Park and seeing Dougie Fresh outside beatboxing with Slick Rick.
Dope.
I was little. I was young. I was there. Like, I grew up around all this shit.
Yeah, it's in your blood.
So, like, hip-hop is definitely, whatever movie it is, I'm hip-hop.
You say we can agree or disagree?
Like, you know, I'm just saying.
No, that's why we, and we I always bring this reference, too. I say Paid in Full's a hip-hop movie. But so
nah, that's not a hip-hop movie. That's a drug dealer
that's
movie.
What he said. So the way he comes at me, like, yo, crack is hip-hop?
Right, so crack is hip-hop?
Well, crack, you know, plays a big part with hip-hop, because
the drug dealers used to
and the music that was being played.
Right, exactly, right.
The music that was being played while everybody was outside selling crack.
Right.
Was
we had also this discussion with Eddie B. Swift. He said Colors. Who he called?
He called Bishop Lamont.
Yeah, and he said Bishop Lamont saying that Colors was a hip hop movie
for Cali.
For Cali,
it was a hip hop movie
for Cali.
Yeah, for Cali.
And I don't.
You know, Bishop Lamont. His explanation was it portrayed and showed their gang lifestyle, which is a part of Cali and a part of their hip hop lifestyle. You know what I mean? So to him, to Bishop Lamont, Colors is definitely a hip hop movie.
And I said, no, you got breaking. The West Coast.
That's to represent the West Coast. That's fucked up.
You got breaking. We got B Street. While I was on. You got breaking.
I don't know. I ain't never even. I saw Colors as gang movie.
Gang movie. Right?
A game movie. Right. Yeah.
The police was involved. Right. And,
yeah.
I gotta watch that movie again.
There's no.
That's so like calling New Jack City a hip hop movie.
Exactly. See, another one.
That's a drug dealer.
Am I my brother's keeper?
So yeah. Scarface is hip hop.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Scarface more disco.
More disco.
That would be a disco movie.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's the cocaine era.
The cocaine era, Studio 54. Studio 54. Yeah, oh,
man, that's crazy. So what's Carlito's way?
Carlito's way? Yeah, it's probably the same thing. I would say same thing, because you got the butterfly collars, you know what I mean?
Oh, disco era. Diddy's in it.
No, but that's the second one.
No, that's trash.
Yeah, that wasn't.
Second one is trash.
Yeah, they fucked up that movie right there. I watched
the storyline. I have no idea what the storyline is.
Yeah, I did watch it.
I watched
it. To support it, you know what I mean? But, you know, nothing better than Al Pacino, man. Yeah.
No, that joint's trash.
Yeah. You got anything else, June?
No, I'm talking about the color shit.
The colors? The oh, I thought he was still his feelings about the sample.
Nah, fuck that. I'm gonna sell him the record. I'm gonna sell him the record. He can remember me every time he's that record now.
So you got any final words to our listeners and viewers?
Be you. Be yourself. Mm-hmm. And all DJs, learn the craft and understand whatever you're trying to get done. Do it the right way. Just do it, believe with yourself. Like, get yourself moving.
Right, 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 right.
And there's a lot of opportunities now, man. You got so many outlets, social media platforms, man. We didn't have that when we grew up.
Yeah, no.
Our joint was, yo, come to my party.
Right. He's a flyer.
He's a flyer, yeah.
Paper flyer with mad graffiti on it.
Yep.
You know what I mean? So just be yourself, man. Any DJ that's trying to be a DJ, learn the music, learn what it takes to be a DJ, your showmanship. Not every DJ has to talk. You right. don't have to talk. Mm-hmm. You know, that's a talent within its own. Your verb game gotta be able to know how to talk and gab and all that, get through it, man. It's just different.
Yeah.
And stop playing so many damn effects in a damn club, man. I hear fin, brr, brr,
yeah,
over fucking UNITY. Like, what's going on, man?
Yeah, that wasn't what that song was about.
Yeah. Or the flex bombs.
The flex bombs. Yeah.
I get it, man.
Everybody want to be flexed, though.
Don't flex, you know what I mean? It's going down. Yeah! Nah, it's my guy.
Start growling.
Lit digital.
Shout out to Flex. These are OGs, man.
Yeah, I was bored in my life. You know what I mean? I used to do voices.
Doing voices. Sound just like Flex, though. I'll give you that for sure.
I used to do that on conference calls, make people mad.
Oh, wow.
You know, like, when people, like, they would get on the phone and be on conference call, be mad DJs. And they'd be like, yeah, who's here? Da-da-da, mad DJs is on the joint. And then I'd just be like, Funk Flex, you know what I mean? It's going down, what up?
And it, people are like, oh, shit.
Yo, Flex is here. Yo, Flex, man, you my idol.
Yo, what's going on?
Yeah, I know.
Start talking that shit.
And then I hang up the phone.
Damn. Yeah.
Now niggas gonna be mad at me. Years later, niggas gonna be mad at me.
He showed up to the conference call. Yeah, you fucked up. How many times?
Oh, shit. Yeah,
how many times you did that?
Yo, they gonna be mad.
How many times you did that on a Rob Love conference call?
Yeah, I used to do that shit a lot of shit, man. It was funny.
Yeah.
Everybody salute Flex.
Yeah, shit. Sure.
You know, keep doing what you're doing out there, Eric. Yeah, I used to make people mad, man.
Damn. After they was pouring their heart out to Flex.
Yo, they were, oh my God. Yo, the cream out, man.
Oh, oh my God. Hey, yo.
The cream out.
Cream out, man. I can't take it, man. I hate groupies, man.
Yeah.
Male groupies are the worst groupies.
Men are the worst groupies, bro.
Yeah.
That's why they moopies. Male groupies.
Moopies?
Moopies.
So we going with it.
They moopies, bro.
Then the t-shirt thing.
We'll put a question with the bottle
moopies, girl. Moopies, man. That shit's the worst.
Yeah, what you think about moopies? And we going to put underneath it, Chubby Chub.
That shit's crazy. If I had a dollar for everybody, it's my dream to meet 50 Cent. If I had a dollar for everybody that told me that.
Be a billionaire, probably.
Yo, B. It's my dream.
You should.
It's my
dream. It's my dream to even meet him.
Get the dollar, turn around. It took like 50.
Nah, you can't do fifth.
Damn.
You can't do fifth.
How you DJing and you haven't met him yet? I'm a little confused.
I don't even know 50, man. Like, come on, man. That's just crazy, man. Like, yo, it's my dream. Like, oh, man. I don't even know 50, man. He's over there. I'm standing over here, man. What you want me to do?
I'm just a DJ.
I'm just a DJ. I show up, do my work.
And just give me my paperwork and that's it, man.
Just stamp my passport and let me go home.
Oh, that's crazy. Like, yo, I'm telling you, I could be in power. Me too,
yo,
man.
They come to you for all that?
Yo.
They don't even
understand, man. Like, yo, I would love to have a meeting. I got a story I want to give them. Yo, man, if I could help you, man, help me.
Help me. Right.
I want to be in power.
I want to be in power.
Right. I've been trying to just carry trash in the show. You know what I mean? I wanted to be the nigga that got shot in this story. Like, let me just play right. 5 minutes.
Yo, you know, that's funny because I know a lot of actors that want to play a dead body in Law and Order.
Yo, I would love to be Liv, you know what I mean? Facts. Yeah, I'm a fan. Yeah.
They want to play a dead body in Law and Order and put that shit on their resume.
SVU, yeah. I'm a fan.
Facts.
I'm down, like, put me in.
I want to be down, Ice-T looking over my body, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
that's him.
That's him.
Yo, yeah. That's it, yo.
He's a known drug dealer from 152nd
Street. Apparently he was eating Twinkies.
Right.
You know what I mean?
And he choked on the cream.
Yo, just put me in.
No broke back. Right. And that's it. I got 5 seconds of fame.
Damn. I'm cool with that, man.
That's what's up. Yeah.
I'm cool with that. Like, let me just stand in the joint.
In the background, yeah.
Oh, word. You just stand in, word.
That's why Uncle J Day Crush Group.
Yeah, he walked in with the boombox.
No, before the boombox, he was in the backstage.
Oh, that's right. Oh, yeah, he was just
like in the backstage, yeah. Like that.
Yeah. It's crazy. Good times, man. Good times.
Oh man.
So how can anyone book you? Get in contact with you?
Shit, he's a 90s talk. They ain't booking shit.
That's a good question though. But in those cities that you out of town, do you do after parties?
Yeah, I do after parties. Do a lot of after parties. The joints be rocking. Overseas is different. Overseas, the love is on 1,000.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, clubs nowadays here is like, it's hookah and everybody chilling and they phone, snap, this, that.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's not no real dancing. Like, overseas, they're still dancing.
Dancing, partying.
But the music that we hear here, not everything is over there. Like, it's there, but it's not there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like 2000 is still big out there.
Okay.
The music of year 2000 is big overseas. Like you never lose with that. Mm. Like that shit will rock forever. Like you could play J-Lo and Fab. Frenzy.
They
Frenzy.
Fog, fucking confetti going.
Bring them out.
Mm. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Anything 50.
Of course.
You know what I'm saying? Nelly, like Luda, like these records are the records that are overseas.
Dope.
That 2000 era Ying Yang Twins,
all that John's shit. Like that.
Yeah, like those are the shit that really rock parties.
That's what's up.
Like he said, they party. They're on the phone. They partying.
They partying. They may do the little hookah and everything, but they party.
They party.
They dance.
They have a
hookahs
time.
Are this fucking big.
Yeah, the hookahs the size of this fucking table.
Yeah, that's crazy. Them hookahs be bugged. They be like some pretty ass hookahs. Like y'all be ready to be like, nah. Just because the shit look mesmerizing.
They got the,
like,
fruit, got the fruit on top.
Nah, it's the pineapple. Just the little glare of the color in there. You be like.
Should be dragging you in.
You start feeling like a fly and shit.
You floating into that motherfucker.
Knocking shit over just because you should look cute.
Face placed up, plastered against the glass, trying to get in there with the smoke and the water and shit.
That's what's up, yo.
So do we even get social media?
Social media? Oh, yeah.
We didn't get
social media at all.
Anything at DJ Chubby Chub. That's all. 1B, not 2Bs. I'm not Chub Rock.
You get confused for Chub Rock?
What up, what?
You get confused for Chub Rock?
Nah, I don't get confused. Nah, but you know, people always end up adding an extra B on Chub.
Okay.
I guess it just sounds right. Because in Brazil, they call me Chubby Chubby. They don't even call me Chubby Chub.
Are you getting.
In Brazil, it's like Chubby Chubby. Yeah,
Chubby Chubby.
They don't even say Chubby Chub. Like Chubby Chubby. Hell noise. Chubby, chubby. They don't even say Chub.
Yeah, at that point, you just give up. And yeah, whatever. You know what I mean?
But nah, Chub Rock is just 2Bs and Chub.
Yeah, it's funny because we know Chill Will was saying that sometimes people call him to book him. And after they going through everything and the fee and everything, and they're like, yo, yeah, so you going to bring Dougie Fresh thinking he Chill Will and Barry B. You know what I'm saying?
That shit sucks.
Yeah, exactly.
Shout out to my man Chill Will.
But we didn't even think of that. He told us, like, yo.
You know, I spelled my name right. I was like, yeah, Chill Will.
Chill Will.
Nah,
that ain't it.
From the east side.
Facts.
I was like,
Get fruity.
Get fruity.
And I'm like, who gets it confused with what? And then he bought that Barry B. Chill Will, yeah. Barry B. Dougie Fresh stuff.
It's funny, Chill Will is on Twitch. Dougie Fresh DJ. He's on Twitch.
Yeah.
So Chill Will's on Twitch. And, you know, they both came in my room. Chill Will for the East Side.
And Chill Will.
And Chill Will. So it's just bug. But then you got to see, Chill Will's joint is way big than Chill Will.
From the East Side.
East Side, he got FTE. Yeah.
Well, it's just longer, right?
So he got FTE in his joint. But yeah, it shit happens.
He said that to me. I was like, oh, shit, I didn't even think about Chill Will from Barry B. I mean, not no disrespect to Chill Will from Barry, but I didn't think about that. The reason why, if I spell his name right, it was because the East Side had
from
to be
from the East Side has to be in there. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like his branding.
His branding.
So that makes sense.
Right, it makes sense.
Yeah,
it's definite.
Stuff like that.
But so, yeah, I don't got the Chubb Rock situation. I'm just saying. You
know. Just Chubby Chubby.
Chubby Chubby.
How can I get the Powell's?
Facts. I want to be Brazilian drug dealer. I'm Powell.
Maybe book three, maybe four.
Book three, book four. It's one book. I don't care. Book of Chubb.
This is crazy.
You know, we appreciate you. So we like to salute, you know, DJ Chubby Chubb for sharing his story with us on Respect the DJs podcast. Many thanks to you, our loyal listeners and viewers. And so always, we have another exciting episode coming up. Stay tuned in. And until then, I've been your host, DJ Kared, alongside DJ Junebug for Respect the DJs podcast.
And we are out. Peace. To the next one.
Street Dreams Music Group. Play that. Play that. Play that.
DJ Clark Kent's talent, passion, and dedication to music have earned him the title of God's favorite DJ. Clark Kent's ability to produce tracks and seamlessly blend different genres of music have made him a legendary figure in the industry. His work has not only influenced hip-hop, but also other genres such as R&B, soul, and rock. And his collaborations with some of the biggest names in music have produced some of the most iconic tracks of our time. Thank you for your contributions to the world of music and for inspiring generations of artists and music lovers alike. Your creativity and innovation have changed the game, and your legacy will continue to live on for years to come. DJ Clark Kent, Respect the DJs podcast, salutes you.
Street Dreams Music Group, play that, play that, play that.
DJ Doo-Wop's creativity and innovation revolutionized the mixtape game and have set a standard that has been emulated by countless DJs across the globe. His ability to incorporate exclusive freestyles and remixes have made his mixtape some of the most sought after in the game. Doo-Wop's work has not only entertained listeners, but also provided a platform for up-and-coming artists to showcase their talent and gain exposure. Doo-Wop's tireless dedication to his craft and his willingness to push boundaries have paved the way for a new era of mixtape culture. Thank you for your contributions to the art of DJing and the mixtape game. Your impact on the industry will not be forgotten, and your legacy will live on forever. DJ Doo-Wop, Respect the DJs podcast, salutes you.